Welcome back to week 5, and this is video 2 of Seawater, where we are going to discuss some of the properties that we just looked at in the last video and how the composition, we change the composition, how the properties change slightly. And it, specifically, we're going to be looking at salinity, temperature, and density, and what those look like in different parts of the oceans. And then when we change one of them, like temperature, what happens to the density and the salinity? Or if we change the salinity, what happens to the density? And this simulation that we're going to be looking at should look a little familiar. The format of it's made by Frank Grantchoff, another geology instructor at PCC. So we are going to look at this beaker of water, and we are going to take a look at these three properties, the salinity, the temperature, and the density. So first, what I want to do is examine the salinity. So when we look at salinity, this is the amount of salt in the seawater, and we look at it in the parts per thousand. That's the little zero over two small zero. So it looks like a little bit like a percent symbol, but it's a little bit different. So if we were to look at 1 part per thousand equals 1 gram, or 0.3 ounces of salt per 1,000 grams, or 2.2 pounds, of seawater. The average salinity of seawater is about 35 parts per thousand. It kind of varies, goes up in certain areas, and goes down in other areas. So if we were to look at how the salinity compares in freshwater, we can see we're pretty close to zero. That makes sense. We get into streams where salinity goes up a little bit, and this is because we're dissolving salts from the rocks and they're being transported out to the oceans through streams, so we're going to have a little bit higher salinity than just straight fresh water. When we get to estuaries, this is where the stream flows into the ocean, we have higher salinity, but still not quite as high as total seawater. And this is because our estuaries, where we have a mixture of ocean water and river water combining, so we have somewhat fresh water mixing with that seawater, so they get this roughly 15 to 30 parts per thousand salinity. When we look at seawater, we can go from 30 to 40 parts per thousand. In some places, like where the Dead Sea or the Mediterranean, we can go even higher than this, because those are areas where you have lots of evaporation, water's leaving those water bodies and leaving all those salts behind. So if you were, if anyone's ever been out into eastern Oregon or into Utah, these are areas where that water is rushing down the mountains and into these basins that don't have an outlet. They don't have an outlet to the ocean. So once that water builds up, it gets really hot, the water evaporates away, and we're left with those salts behind. excuse me. So it's seawater. As we get into drier and drier areas, we can get higher and higher salinity levels. So when we look at temperature, temperature, this is basically the rate of molecular motion. So the higher the temperature, the more energy those molecules have, the more they bounce around. We have freezing temperature of pure water is 0 degrees Celsius, or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. Boiling temperature of pure water is 100 degrees Celsius, or 212 degrees Fahrenheit. And you can see here how we go in the ocean water. We can usually things range from 0 or below 0 to maybe, 20 to 40, depending on where you are in the globe. So density of water, this is the mass per unit volume. The higher the density, the heavier the water is, and we measure in grams per cubic centimeter. So ice floats on water, so it has a lower density. Fresh water is kind of in the middle. Seawater has all those dissolved salts in it, so it has a higher density. So if we were to look at an area where we have fresh water flowing into seawater is going to be at the bottom, the fresh water is going to stay at the top because it has a lower density. The heavier something is, the more salts present, the more likely it is that it's going to sink to the bottom of that ocean. So what happens when we change these things? So if we start, say, with our salinity, right now we have in our beaker of water, we have average salinity in our oceans. We have 35 parts per thousand. We have our temperature right in the middle at 15 degrees Celsius, and we can see our density is on the relatively high side. Now, if we change our salinity to zero, go to fresh water conditions, temperature stays the same, you can see our density goes down because we have removed those salts from that water. So if we go back up to our average seawater salinity, and let's see what happens when we change the temperature. Let's say we go down to polar conditions. Down to polar conditions, we see our density goes up just a slight amount. And the reason for that is we might have a lot of our water freezing and leaving those salts behind. So we go up a little bit. Let's go down a little bit more to -5. You can see our beaker has completely frozen solid. And when we have water freezing, structure of those ice crystals can't fit the salts in them, so the salts get left behind, and we end up with our ice being pretty much totally fresh water. So our salinity goes down to zero because our salt isn't in that ice crystal structure, and our density goes way down because our water is frozen. We go back up to zero, things are still pretty solid, low salinity. We go up to 5, things have melted. We have our density a little bit higher, 1. And then if we go up to 10, 15, 20, not much change here, but we do see that our density is slowly getting lower. And if you think of warm things like a hot air balloon, the reason why a hot air balloon rises up into the air is because the air inside that balloon is being heated by that flame that the hot air balloon pilot is pulling on, heating the air inside the balloon, causing the air to be warmer, causing it to be less dense, and causing it to rise. So if we have warmer temperature water, warmer temperatures mean lower density water. Cooler temperatures to a point, we have higher density. So if I go lower here, you can see our density gets even higher because we have cooler water. So let's go back up to our 35 parts per million. And we should see if we have, we start with some lower temperature water. Our density is a little over 1, so pretty dense. We get higher and higher. We see our density kind of varies. It actually goes lower as we increase our temperature. And that makes sense. We have lower or higher temperature water. Our density is going to go down, and we're going to cause that material to rise. And then if we go here, we check out our 35 parts per million. If we decrease it down to zero, our density should drop, and it does. So we have a few things going on here. We have more saline the water is, the more dense it's going to be, so it can sink to deeper depths. When we look at the temperature of the water, the higher the temperature, the lower the density, and it's going to be kind of sitting at the top, whereas our cooler water is going to be higher density, and it's going to sink to the bottom. You have some cool graphs in your textbook that will help you out with this when we get to lab, so make sure you look those over before coming to class. So that's kind of how things vary and change when we change the properties or composition of water, increase, decrease salinity. We can change the density of that water as well. We'll sign off and come back and talk about how we actually collect that seawater.